happy this evening. Can I hear your hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
If the rain was not able to stop you, can I hear your hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
Soon you will realize that it's actually a shower of blessings.
Yes, sir.
As long as it could not stop you, it becomes a shower of what?
Blessing.
Is that person here?
Yes, sir.
As long as you defy the rain, it becomes what?
Showers of blessing.
Amen.
If you're that person now, you're celebrating God. Just celebrate God, celebrate God, celebrate God. Celebrate God, celebrate God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Please sit down, please sit down, please sit down, please sit down. I've been with my brothers this morning, going around town, seeing some things in town. And you know, it's been long. I visited Umar here last, so many years ago. The first time I visited Umar here actually was 1987, to be precise. Yeah, then I was my university, FUT Owerri, Student Union Secretary General. And we came for a NAS meeting here. That was how I was privileged to visit Umuahia for the very first time. And the second time was when my brother brought me to Umuahia. And this is the third time I'm visiting Umuahia. Amen. Celebrate God. Amen. I truly want to say again that I'm impressed with what is happening here. And I'm also impressed with the caliber of people that God has given to him. Amen. Amen. You see, it's God that gives you men. You can't struggle for it. It's God that gives you men. It is a gift. The gift of men. You see, if you don't have the gift of men, you will not go far. Without you, you will not go far. And be honest with you. Without you, will it be preaching to empty chairs? So without you, it will not go far. So you are a gift unto him. Celebrate yourself again for that gift. Amen. 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 You are gifts. You are gifts. You see, any pastor who doesn't appreciate his members doesn't understand. Because you are a gift. You are God's shepherd. You are God's sheep, I mean. And God can decide to say, look, you will not be here. Am I correct? But for God to bring you here, it means you are a gift unto him. That's what he supplies. So as long as God has planted you here, I strongly believe that that which God has laid upon his life will definitely be imparted into your lives also. God did not bring him all the way from Owerri. I know he's from the east, but God did not bring him all the way from Owerri to come and look at trees. They are for definite purpose. And he's fulfilling an assignment. And you are part of that assignment. You are part of that assignment. So I want to plead with you to understand that when you are here, like as you said yesterday, see it as a word, family. And we said family people get involved in family matters. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
And it is only when you get involved that you truly become what? A family. If you're not involved, you're not what? A family. And what was the other thing we said again? Fellow what? Worker. And what was the third thing we said? Fellow soldier. And we said that I am not your enemy, you are not my enemy. We have a common word, enemy. And we have one commander and one word, enemy. So if we have one enemy, why are we fighting with ourselves? We can't fight ourselves because we have a common enemy that we need to deal with. Join hands together to deal with. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I want to assure you that the Lord is going to empower your hand to crush your enemies tonight. Yeah. Don't forget, the Lord told us that the rest of this year shall be the best for you.
Yeah.
Was that for somebody?
Yes, sir.
Was that for anybody here?
Yes, sir.
The rest of this year shall be the best for you.
Amen.
What happened in January is gone.
Yes, sir.
What happened in February is gone.
Yes, sir.
What happened in March is also what?
Gone.
What about what happened in April?
Yeah, gone, sir.
What about May?
Gone.
What about June?
Gone.
But the rest of this year shall be the best for you.
Amen.
That is whether the devil likes it or not.
Yes, sir.
Tomorrow when you are coming, you must come with somebody.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
One of our senior brothers will be preaching tomorrow. Amen. So when you are coming tomorrow, come with somebody. Don't allow rain to stop you.
Yes, sir.
Close your shop and come.
Yes, sir.
I understand. This is not business, you understand? I understand. Business is strong for this area. You know so? I understand. Because I school for East, so I understand. But the point is that close your shop and do what?
Come.
Because that shop, God gave it to you. Now, wow. I'm not sure somebody understands. What you have not sold for 1 week, who say you cannot sell it for 1 day? Is it possible?
Yes, sir.
It is possible. It's just that we don't even believe. We confess that we believe God, though. Just that we don't even believe what God can do. God told the children of Israel, so for 6 years, for one good year, don't sow, don't harvest. Your harvest of the sixth year will carry you to the eighth year. Can you imagine that? But we don't really believe what God can do. We say it with our mouth. In most cases, it is just a mental assent to us. It is not in our heart. Because if it's in your heart, you will know that if I do this for his sake, if I do this, if I close my shop even for a whole day for his sake, I know God is able and abundantly to give me that which will surpass my expectation. You think it's because the shop is open? Do you know God can command people, even that are not even from this town, just be going, go to that, there's a shop, just be going. And we pass in other shops, I will come straight to your shop.
Yes,
is it possible?
Yes, sir.
And there will not be any hard customer. There will be good customer that will buy good goods and pay cash. They will not hold credit. In fact, you will give them change.
Yes, sir.
Can God do it?
Yes, sir.
You sure God can do it?
Yes, sir.
Is it possible?
Yes, sir.
Is it possible?
Yes, sir.
It is not because your shop is open. We are getting things wrong. We are turning things upside down. That was why yesterday God said he's looking for committed people. He's looking for people who are ready to risk their business, risk their lives, risk their resources for his pleasure. And when God, you see, he was talking about Jonathan and David. Jonathan risked his throne for David. And to look as if the father called him foolish. So said, Jonathan, you are what? Foolish. As long as this man called David is alive, you cannot inherit his throne. That was prophetic, am I right?
Yes, sir.
But Jonathan told him that let this covenant be between me, not only between me and you, but between our children. And did it happen? It happened. You are here this evening and you think that things have gone haywire. And you don't seem to know what to do. There are so much obstacle, so much roadblock. Because the roadblock, you have been so distracted. The Lord said, I should tell you, there is nothing the devil will put in front of you that is greater than what the Lord has put inside of you.
Amen.
I'm not sure the person is here.
Yes, sir.
There is nothing the devil, there is no challenge the devil will put in front of you that is greater than what God has put inside of you.
I hear you, sir.
Nothing. I repeat, nothing.
Nothing.
Is it diabetes? Is it cancer? Is it kidney failure? Is it business failure?
Nothing.
Is it marital issue?
Nothing.
There is nothing the devil will put in front of you that is greater than what God has put inside of you.
Amen.
I hear you, sir.
In all day. I say in all
day.
It's just that many times we don't even believe God. Many times we don't really believe God, or maybe we believe God, but we are so distracted by what we hear. We are so distracted by our challenges. We are so distracted by what we are seeing. What we see is giving us serious distraction. And as a result, we believe now that those things are speaking. I agree, those things are speaking to you. They are speaking. Your challenge is speaking to you. Your marital challenge is speaking to you. The infertility is speaking to you. You are saying, God, well, how long will I wait to carry my baby? Those things are speaking to you. But I want you to understand something this evening. For me, I will not dwell on the message of the devil. What the devil is saying to me will not be my meditation.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What the devil is saying to me will not be my meditation.
Amen.
It will not be my imagination.
Amen.
It will not be what I'm seeing.
Amen.
I will rather see what God is saying. That's why the songwriter say, I'm not moved by what I see. Hallelujah. I'm not moved by what I hear. Hallelujah. I'm only moved by the word of God. Hallelujah. I'm only moved by the word of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen.
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 What the devil is saying cannot be my meditation. No way. What my situation is saying cannot be my imagination. No way. My imagination shall be what the Lord has said. My meditation shall be what the Lord has said. What has the Lord said concerning that situation? It's more important than what the devil is saying to you.
I hear you, sir.
Is somebody hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget this. Even if it's a marital challenge that the devil has placed in your front, don't allow that to be your meditation.
Yes, sir.
Just keep going according to what God has said. You may not understand, but keep going. It's just like, let me give an answer. How do I? Okay, let me. This story you want, but I hope you can see him from. Show people can see it from here.
Yes,
come,
sir.
Come. You see, no, let's assume that you will close your eyes. Because many times we are moved by what we see. So at times it's better you close your eye and try to hear from the Lord and meditate upon what God is saying. Because God says the Lord is better than what the enemy is saying. When I say thus says the Lord, yeah, I'm not necessarily saying some when prophecy. I'm simply saying the sure word of prophecy. Amen.
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 Is somebody hearing me?
Yes, sir.
He's not seeing me. Okay, good. You see, are you seeing that? We may not feel God. We may not see Him. We may not be able to touch Him. But can we just trust His voice? Can we just trust His voice? You see this thing in front, it's an obstacle. To some it's a business obstacle. To some it's an academic obstacle. To some it's a marital obstacle. For some it has to do with relationship. You have, one is broken, another one is broken. And you say your heart is broken, your heart is not broken in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Is somebody getting the picture?
Yes, sir.
So that you will not allow what the devil is saying to you to be your meditation. Now, Jerry, okay? Jerry. I want you to lift up your right leg as if you are taking a match. Lift it up well. Up, up, up more. And drop, take a long drop off. Lift it up and take a long drop. Go, take it down. Take a long drop up. Just pass it. Up, up, and then, yes, to me, yes. Come towards me. Come, yeah, good. Take your second leg. Good. Which voice made you to take that step? My voice? Do you know what was placed before you? There was an obstacle. Many a times we are focused on the obstacle. We're not focused on what God is saying. Our meditation is the obstacle and not what God is saying. And as long as the meditation becomes your obstacle, that obstacle remains your what? Your obstacle. It becomes your meditation. It becomes what you are seeing. It becomes your imagination. And the human mind has a way of magnifying things. And as you keep seeing that obstacle, the enemy will begin to make it larger and larger and larger and larger, and becomes a mighty stronghold. And when it becomes a stronghold, it has become your meditation. Tonight, whatever the enemy is saying will not be your meditation.
Amen.
Now, you are going to hear another voice. You should be able to distinguish which voice you will follow. Either the voice of this obstacle or the voice of God. I just hope you recognize my voice. But another man will speak now that will look like my voice. And I will see what you will do. Because that is where the challenge lies.
Mr. Jerry, go back a little bit. Nothing is worrying about you. Don't worry. Just go back. Go back a little bit. Go back a little bit, please. Go back a little bit.
You see, my children recognizes my word. My voice. The voice of the devil, they will not word. Which voice are you hearing? Sit down. Which voice are you hearing? In that situation, which voice are you hearing? I'm not making light of what you are going through. I told yesterday and he confirmed it to you what I went through in 2018. There are situations you are going through, you may not be able to pray. You may not understand, I'm telling you the truth. You won't be able to pray, you never see anything. There are situations you are going through, you won't be able to pray. That is where you need family. That is where you need the church family.
Yes, sir.
That is where you need your immediate family.
Yes, sir.
You need everybody there to join hands with you and pray for you. At my level, there was a time in 2018 I could not pray for myself again. I said, God, what is this? And God gave me a scripture. Psalm 119. And he said I should just be reading it morning, day, and night. Morning, day, and night. And I was that and my, thank God, as at this time, my first boy was doing NYC, so he was in town. The other two were in holidays. So everybody was what? At home. A point came when I could not hide it again. I have to tell the church leaders, I said, I need your prayers. My wife was suddenly, she when I say something, she will rebuke me. Say, why are you talking like this? You see, a time will come, you don't understand. You will not get to that level in Jesus' name.
Amen.
But I repeat, you will not be able to pray for yourself. That is why you need this family. To stand in the gap for you. To stand in the gap for you. To hold one another for you. This body took 366 injections. And it's as if nothing was happening. My son will read this scripture to me morning and night. That became my meditation. I will take medication. I will go for dialysis. I will take God's medication. What I was not doing, I'm serious. If I tell you I was praying seriously that time, it's a lie. I'm not the type who come and babose you, say, that time I'm praying. Like it's a lie from the pit of hell. But I was meditating upon the scriptures that was being read to me. I was meditating upon it. That became a meditation. Kidney failure no longer became a meditation. Is somebody hearing me?
Yes, sir.
That obstacle no longer became my meditation. Was the obstacle there? Yes, it was there. Was the challenge there? Yes, it was there. Was I going through dialysis? Yes, I was going through dialysis. In fact, let me shock you. The phase 2 diagnosis was prostate cancer.
No.
No, you see, the fact that you have been given a verdict of cancer, that is enough to begin to kill you. Man of God, let me smart you. The first 2 diagnoses were prostate cancer. When it was time for surgery, doctor said, but I'm examining you, I'm not seeing cancer. But your prostate is still large and the kidney is still compromised. I said, so what do you want to do? He said, I will carry an operation. Let's see how. operation failed.
What manner of man is Jesus? Hallelujah.
What manner of man is Jesus? Hallelujah.
You know, our God is a mighty God.
Yes, sir.
He knows when you cannot help yourself.
That's true, sir.
Ne do, is it Jesus? Chetamo, Onyo Wamara, Ike Nebube, is it Nemerongwa? Chetamo.
What is that obstacle that you are facing? That has become your meditation. It has become like evil wig for you that you wear every day. People have even seen it written all over your face. As if you are the only one carrying problem. What is it that you think God cannot handle? God is changing somebody's meditation.
Amen.
I said this evening, God is changing somebody's meditation.
Amen.
You must begin to see what God is saying about that condition. Not until my meditation changed, situation did not change. The obstacle was no longer my meditation. I was not following the word of God. As he was following the voice of God, the voice of God is the word of God.
Yes, sir.
As he was following my voice, he was able to overcome the word, the obstacle. Do you want to overcome obstacles in your life?
Yes, sir.
Let the word of God be your meditation. I have not said challenges will not show up. Have I said so?
No, sir.
They will show up. I have not said the enemy will not rear up his ugly head. He will rear up his ugly head. I have not said that you will not have issues, even in your job. Issues will rear up their ugly head. But what do you see? Is it the issue of blocked fallopian tube? Or no fallopian tube? Is that what you are seeing? But today I'm saying your meditation needs to change. I have members who had issues. They were not even ovulating for many years. No ovulation. No ovulation. But God did it for them. I may not know, I repeat, what that obstacle is to you. We'll be praying. All I'm saying, somebody's meditation needs to change. That's all I'm saying. And then somebody also need to know how to issue commands. Even your weakness, you can still rebuke the devil. In your weakness, you can still just mutter. It's not by long prayers. It's by that word that is coming of faith. Word of faith coming from your heart. It's not by the length of prayers. So if it was the length of prayers, I won't be standing here. I'm being honest with you. If it has to do with length of prayers, I won't be standing here. It is not the length of prayers, but learn how to issue simple command. Kidney failure. Just go. Get out. palaces. I have no business with you. Fallopian tube. I'm carrying my baby. I am carrying my baby. Oh, lost bank account. Is that the challenge? Wait, let me be honest with your assessment. Which one is easier to handle? Low spend count or kidney failure? Low spend count now. So if God could handle kidney failure, we could not be able to handle low spend count? What about that waste thing you say you carry? Kidney failure and waste thing, which one is more easier to handle? But your God handled kidney failure. So will he not be able to handle waist pain?
Yes, sir, he can.
What about arthritis? What about diabetes? Is it ulcer? Ulcer we go tonight.
Jesus now, more than ever, we are sailing in stormy weather. All your children, reach them together, for we need Jesus now, more than ever. Jesus now, more than ever, we are sailing in stormy weather. Oh, your children, we come together, for we need Jesus now. Yes, we need Jesus now, more than ever.
If you have noticed since yesterday, this is how I preach. Just going gradually, amen. It's like we are just talking as friends, am I right?
Yes, sir.
In Acts chapter 16, in the 16th verse, something happened. Because some of us, we have tolerated some things long enough. We have tolerated some things long enough. And we need to deal with it, amen. Once when we are going to the place of prayer, take note, they were going to the house of God to pray. But we are met by a slave girl who had a spirit by which she predicted the future. She earned a great deal of money for her owners by what? Fortune telling. But that is not my concern here. We are going somewhere. This girl followed Paul. And the rest of us shouting, these men are servants of the Most High God who are telling you the way of the Lord. Is she lying? She's not lying. But something happened. She kept this all for how many days?
Many days.
How many days?
Many days.
And the scripture says, finally, Paul became so what?
Trouble.
That he did what?
He turned around.
And said what?
To the spirit.
To who?
To the spirit.
To who?
To the spirit.
To who?
To the spirit.
What did he say?
In the name of Jesus Christ, I command you to come out of her.
At that moment, what happened?
The spirit, left her.
You see, for some of us, it to be the spirit of poverty that we must go tonight.
Amen.
Paul tolerated this girl for many days. In some passage, he said for a long time. What have you tolerated in your life, in your business? You may just be enjoying it. That's why you're tolerating it. You don't like it, but you're tolerating it. You don't want it, but you are somehow, you are just passionate with it. What have you permitted in your life? January, you allowed it. You permitted it. February, you permitted it. March, you permitted it. April, you permitted it. May, you permitted it. June, you go, permitted it. And now we're in the month of July. It must end, though.
Amen.
Is somebody with me?
Yes, sir.
What have you tolerated? For Apostle Paul and the others, they tolerated this girl for a long time. Apostle Paul knew that this girl was not speaking from God, am I right? He knew from the scripture, he knew. But he allowed it. Permitted it in the church. Permitted it in the household. What are you permitting in the church? Permitting your house? Permitting your business? Permitting in your home? What are you permitting? What have you tolerated that you ought to have even exercised? And some of this permission is keeping you not married even up to now. That spirit must go.
Amen.
I said that spirit must go.
Amen.
It is a demon. For me, I prefer to command demons than to command human beings. Because here, the scripture says that he commanded the spirits. Not even the girl. It's not the girl. There is a spirit behind her action. Behind that, your action is a spirit. Behind that sickness, there could just be a word, a spirit. So when you deal with the spirit, even Panadol becomes cure unto you. That's the difference. Do you get it?
Yes, sir.
When you deal with the spirit, as an ordinary Panadol becomes what?
Cure.
I've not said you should not take medication, but I'm saying when you deal with the spirit, ordinary Panadol becomes what?
Cure.
That is how things work. Is how things work. Say with me, I command.
Delay.
To stop now.
In my marriage, stop now.
In my business, stop now.
In my job,
stop now.
In my pregnancy,
stop now.
In my career,
stop now.
Now.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You see, many a times we unduly permit things.
Yes, sir.
We unduly allow things. It may be something that is against your wife, and you know that this thing is against your wife, but you have allowed it. It may be against your husband, but you have permitted it. It may even be against your father. It is something must be happening. You know, if you go for Egypt, for some of us, we are the first generation Christian in our family. We came from a family that is not Christian-like at all. And therefore, so we have many battles to fight. Somebody hearing me? We had to fight the spirit of death, spirit of lack. Many things we need to fight so many things. But some of us, we have permitted it. You have seen that in your family. Your father died young. Your mother died young. And you are not issuing commands. What is happening? You saw what happened to your mother.
happened to your aged sister, the same thing. The way your father, that means the husband to your mother, the way your father died young, your aged sister, also her husband died young, and you think there is nothing wrong, and you're not issuing commands, and you're just tolerating it, you are likely to continue to cover it.
I want to say tonight, you are going to issue some commands.
Amen.
Amen.
Those things must stop.
Amen.
I said they must stop.
Amen.
I said they must stop.
Amen.
They cannot follow you again.
Amen.
Say whatever.
Whatever.
It's against my wife.
Or
my husband.
Or my husband.
My father.
My father.
My mother.
My mother.
My business.
My business.
My life.
My life.
You cannot follow me again.
You will not 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 follow me again.
January up till now. Is that not enough time to let them go?
Please.
It is enough time to let them go. Why are you enjoying their company? Why are you enjoying the company of people die young in your family? Why are you enjoying the company of marriages breaking in your family? Why are you enjoying the company of people not getting married in your family? What are you tolerating? What are you permitting? Unknowingly, you are permitting it. Unknown to you, you have tolerated it. Unknown to you, you have even authorized it.
Belongs to you.
Help me with that song. Come on.
My hallelujah.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Again, so that you can understand something there. You will see praying. Look at the verse 18 again. She kept this all for how many days?
Many days.
The number of days we don't know. Just as for some of us, we have kept this going for years in our family. We have kept this challenge going for years in our household. We have kept the challenge going in our business, in our job. We have kept it going. Even ahead challenge that you ought to issue command to, we have permitted it. We are not doing what we need to do. we are now see the health challenge as okay, it's part of now. So the now see the bonus na na everybody die with diabetes for my family, so no problem. I go see the way to eat, die. That has become the person's meditation. Somebody say, you will not allow it again.
You will not allow it again.
But something happened here that I want to see. It's not just to say with mouth. You don't get to a Christian to a level. And what is that level? This just say finally. Somebody say finally.
Finally.
Somebody say finally.
Finally.
Paul became what?
Troubled.
Has that thing actually troubled you to the point where you are ready to issue instructions? How troubled are you about that situation? How troubled are you about that condition? How troubled are you about what you are going through? How agitated are you? He said, not until you became restless, you will not break the yoke out of your world, out of your neck. Is anybody angry tonight?
Yes, sir.
Wherever you are at home, is anybody angry tonight?
Yes, sir.
You watching us online, are you angry tonight?
Yes, sir.
If you are angry, then something's about to happen.
Amen.
I will simply mention some things and you will say, come out. Because he said, in the name of Jesus Christ, I command you to do what?
To come out.
We understand the instruction?
Yes.
Yeah.
I may not mention your case directly, but you should imply it. That situation is coming out.
Amen.
The spirit behind it is coming out.
Amen.
The spirit behind it is coming out.
Amen.
The spirit behind it is coming out.
Amen.
And I told you, you know the beauty of it all. When we deal with the spirit, ordinary paradox becomes what?
Negation.
That is the beauty of it all. When I began to meditate and dwell upon the word of the Lord, that time I have taken 366 injections already. 366. It was the doctor that told me that would dismantle. And the doctor was a little bit careless also. I didn't know he was a Jehovah's Witness person. My blood level was damn low. You know, they don't believe in a blood transfusion. That alone was enough to even kill me. But God has a purpose.
Yes, sir.
God has a purpose for your life.
Amen.
God has a purpose for your life.
Amen.
God has a purpose for your life.
Amen.
Your time is not now.
Amen.
You will fulfill your days.
Amen.
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 You will fulfill your days.
Amen.
You will fulfill your days.
Amen.
Is that person here?
Yes, sir.
Don't forget what I said. Some things I said earlier. Don't allow obstacle to become your word, your meditation. Don't allow the obstacle to become your imagination self. Don't allow it. Please don't allow it. God wants to do something here this evening.
Amen.
Somebody's life will have a turnaround.
Amen.
Somebody's business will have a turnaround.
Amen.
Because we are dealing with the spirit behind it, therefore, things will begin to fall into place and places.
Amen.
Things will happen in a way you don't even expect.
Amen.
Things will not become like dream unto you.
Amen.
Because when the Lord turns the captivity, he said, it was like what?
A dream.
like unto thee.
Hey! 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 H For some of you to be like a false cough, cough it out. Let it go. Out in the
just let it go.
I bind your hands of it.
Amen. When I mention a particular spirit, you will say, come out now. People have received their healing already.
Amen.
People people have been released from delay in marital issue already.
Amen.
We expect your marriage to be announced this year.
Amen.
Amen. The delay is over.
Amen.
The delay is over.
Amen.
The delay is over.
Amen.
The delay is over.
Amen.
The delay is over.
Amen.
The delay is over.
Amen.
The delay is over.
Amen.
The delay is over.
Amen.
The delay is over.
Amen.
The delay is over.
Amen.
The delay is over.
Amen.
The delay is over.
Amen.
It is over.
Amen.
Shaboto seti drakatasha. Libras canto shaking the rabashi. Mando bros second the shikarabashi. Mankum Dahalabashi Kendesia Libras Kento Hulabashi Libras Sakantashi Tarabashi. Come out now, not me, amen. Make sure that particular spirit, eh? Are we ready?
Yes, sir.
Are we ready?
Yes, sir.
Spirit of lack,
come out now.
Spirit of delay,
come out now.
Spirit of sickness,
come out now.
Of diabetes,
come out now.
Of high blood pressure,
come out now.
Of waist pain,
come out now.
Of lungs enlargement,
come out now.
Of kidney failure.
Thank you, Lord.
You are afraid of death. You are here, you are afraid of death. But the Lord is saying, today's the end.
Amen.
When is the end?
Now.
Spirit of fear.
Now.
Of wrong associations,
come out now.
You may not know it's even a spirit. You want to get married, and you have somebody who has been associating with you. You think that is who God meant for your life. It's a lie. It's a wrong association. Not until that person leaves, somebody will not come.
Yes, sir.
And if you're not careful, you are marking time there. And because you are not seeing what God is seeing, you are not listening to what God is saying, you are marking time there. You are just wasting time there. That spirit must leave you tonight.
Amen.
So that you can move forward.
Amen.
Spirit of infertility,
come out now.
Spirit of stagnation,
come out now.
When is that stagnation coming out?
Now.
When is it coming out?
Now.
In your business, when?
Now.
In your academics, when?
Now.
In your job, when?
Now.
In your career, when?
Now.
When?
Now.
I say 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 when?
Now.
It is over in the name of Jesus. Mando second to Shikara was a Mando second to Shikanaba.
Namiki Book Iken Jabba. Namiki Tamu.
You are the last God in this world.
us lay hand on you. As we were praying, some people were really versed in their spirit. And I can see angels of God ministering to you.
Amen.
That delay is broken.
Amen.
That embargo is lifted.
Amen.
It is lifted.
Amen.
It is lifted.
Amen.
It is lifted.
Amen.
It is lifted.
Amen.
I'm going to anoint your hands. You must carry something this year.
Amen.
You must carry.
Amen.
I say you must carry.
Yes, sir.
I say you must carry.
Amen.
I say you must wait.
Carry.
Amen.
This one has nothing to do with the anointing of the hand, but the Lord is saying quickly, it has nothing to do with the anointing. I will tell you what I want to do now. I will tell you what it implies at the end of the service. You are here, you know you can lay a seed of 20,000. Don't come and just lift up your hand, 20,000. I'm laying myself to a seed of 20,000. Just tomorrow you are bringing it. Tomorrow, not today, tomorrow you are bringing it. 20,000 only. 20,000, 20,000, 20,000. Just lift up your hand, that's all. Lift it up so that I will know. Just 20,000. If you can join there for 10,000, join there for 10,000. Tomorrow you are bringing it. If you can give it today, wonderful. If you can't bring it today, tomorrow bring it. 10,000. The list is 5,000. 5,000. Quickly. Now, let me tell you what the Lord wants to do with. I repeat, this has nothing to do with the prayers I want to pray. It has nothing to do with the oil. Yeah, upon your hand. Psalm 20 verse 1. Open it quickly. I'll tell you what God wants to do for you. Something, some of you who just indicated your interest, some things was about to happen, but you will see what will happen. God is going to do something in your life. Is somebody hearing me? May the Lord answer you when you are in distress.
Amen.
May the name of Jacob protect you.
Amen.
Look at verse 2 quickly. For those of you who indicated, though, don't fear to bring it tomorrow. I'm serious about it. Don't fear to bring it tomorrow. Me, I will transfer my own. Even if I, but as I'm going in the car, if I get the account number, I'll transfer my own. May he send help from the sanctuary and grant you support.
Amen.
Some this class of people, you need support system. You need support system. Somebody hear me? You need support system. You need it. And it shall be your portion.
Amen.
But that is not enough. So that you say, may he remember your sacrifices.
Amen.
And accept your offerings.
Amen.
This offering you are giving now. Offering you are giving now, may the Lord remember it for good.
Amen.
May he answer you when you are in distress.
Amen.
May he send you support where you need support.
Amen.
May he send you support where you need support.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Come on up us. Amen. The purpose of the anointing of all your hands, primarily, some of you must carry your weight this year.
Amen.
Don't forget, the Lord said at the beginning of this meeting, he said, the rest of the year shall be best for you.
Amen.
this year shall be best in your business.
Amen.
Best in your job.
Amen.
Best in your marriage.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Are you ready for this anointing?
Yes.
Your hands will be empowered.
Amen.
To carry the kind of money you have not carried before.
Amen.
To handle the kind of money you have not handled before.
Amen.
You will handle it.
Amen.
You will handle it.
Amen.
You will handle it.
Amen.
But let me warn and head. Is it Luke chapter 12? The parable of the man who's got heavy harvest. Heavy harvest. And he was thinking, what will I do with the harvest? And increase came. Increase came. Nothing wrong with increase. Increase will come in your life. Amen.
Amen.
But when increase came unto this man, media, if you can see that, I know it's chapter 12, Luke chapter 12, I can't remember the exact verse. When increase came, you know what happened? The man said, what will I do with this increase? Nothing wrong with that. The man went and said, okay, I am going to break down my barn and build what? New one. Nothing wrong with business expansion. But the question is, when God grants you the increase, what will come to your mind first? Is it God or yourself? You will realize that a point came when God, after the man has expanded his business, the boom was so much. He expanded his business. Nothing wrong with expanding your business. Nothing wrong with investing. Nothing wrong with saving. But for some of us, when we get increase, what comes to our mind first is, I never eat for that restaurant for a long time. I can first go to where to eat. I say, God punish Satan. I can go eat for that way. I can square myself. You understand? Hello?
Hi.
I mean, of us are like that. You understand? For some of us, we will say, not be so. I have not changed my answer. First thing, let me do what? Hello?
Hi, sir.
Small force will say, this when I bone straight, I'm not bone bend. Push up. When me never wear before, I must wear it. I must wear them. The first thing that comes to your mind is to go and buy bone. Hello?
Hi, sir.
Nothing wrong with buying bone straight if you have the money, amen?
Amen.
But what went wrong with this man? That's the question I must ask myself. Because then he said, this is what I will do. I will tear down my barns and build bigger ones. And there I will store all my wool, grain and my goods. Look at the next verse. The next verse says that, and I will say to myself, you have plenty of good things laid up for many years. Take life, what?
Easy.
Eat and what? And do I have what?
Be merry.
Hello. I'm in a force, including myself. Some of us go down. What is the happening restaurant in town? The happening eatery in town. Which one be the happening one? Eh? The choice. See levels. So the first place you will go now, where?
The choice.
Your friends gonna know say we find the moment you enter the choice, the way you do work, they're gonna say you don't come. Levels are doing. Okay. Nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with going to the church, to the choice. Nothing wrong with that. But look at something happened. But God said to him, you what? This very night, your life will be what? Demanded from you. Then who will get what you have what? Prepare for yourself. What is the problem here? Nothing wrong with what the man did. Only one thing is wrong here. Dear ever God. All by what? Himself. Is it about God? So my encouragement to you is that, please, when increase comes to your life, the first thing you should think about, let me remove God on first. Is somebody hearing me?
Yes, sir.
The only thing that will make you not to be a fool is if you remember what? Remember God. But if you don't remember God, God calls you what? Increase is going to come. Oh. Take what you want to do not lightly, increase will come.
Amen.
But I'm just sending this warning ahead. as money begins to come to your hand, do what? Remember who?
God.
First. I'm begging you. Because whether you buy 10 cars, you will not take them to anywhere. I'm begging you this. Please. Who will you remember first?
God.
In fact, your first transfer or your first check should go to who?
God.
Take God tight, come out. Remove God tight, come out. God who gave you 100%. You think he cannot give you more?
He can, sir.
Please, don't allow God to call you what?
Yes.
Somebody hear him?
Yes, sir.
Quickly, let's come.
You're my only,
no. Oh, yeah.
in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.